Hi everybody, welcome back to the Macworld video. I'm editorial director Jason Snell, and today I'd like to talk about Twitter on the iPhone. Now, if you don't like the iPhone and you don't like Twitter, you might want to make yourself a sandwich instead of watching this video. If you are interested in Twitter, if you do have an iPhone or an iPod Touch, then I want to show you a new Twitter app for the iPhone. It has a familiar name, Twitterific, which is a Mac app, and actually the first version of Twitterific has been on the iPhone since day one. But there's a new version, and I want to give you an early look at Twitterific 2.0, which should be out either by the time you're watching this or shortly thereafter, from the Icon Factory. So I want to give you a little tour of what's new in Twitterific 2, which I think is the best Twitter app that's out there for the iPhone. And then I want to show you a couple other contenders that are also very good. One called Tweety, which I actually, up to a couple weeks ago, was using on my iPhone and is very good. And one called Twittilator Pro, which is sort of the power user app for Twitter on the iPhone. It's got every feature imaginable. Anyway, let's get started with a look at Twitterific 2.0. So here's Twitterific. This is the premium version I'm going to show you here. This is my timeline. These are tweets from the people that I've been following on Twitter, and I can scroll around to read them. That's pretty simple. If I tap on this tweet, I can tap on the @JDalrymple. You see that reference to a person who's highlighted, and it'll load the information pane about Jim Dalrymple. That's information about who he is and how many followers he's got. I can follow or unfollow him directly from here, as well as block him. And if I tap on the little clock icon up in the top, I can actually even see a list of all of his tweets. So it's a great way, if somebody mentions somebody in a tweet, you can immediately tap through and see who they are and what they're doing. Now, if I tap on a web link, it'll load the browser, which is a standard feature, but there's a lot more you can do now with this stuff. If you tap on the asterisk in the lower left corner, you can do a lot of things, open it in Safari, but the one that I've just tapped is Instapaper. It'll add the page that you're on to Marco Arment's Instapaper service. And if you haven't seen the Instapaper app yet, check it out. So let's see what else I can do. If I tap on a tweet and I tap on the reply button, it'll automatically make a reply to the tweet that I was selecting. And those tabs there let you toggle between a bunch of different tweet options. You can post it as a new tweet. You'll see there's no longer a reference. I can send a direct message to Dan Frakes, or I can tap back and turn it back into a reply to him. Now, if I tap on the eye icon there off on the right side, you'll see that it slides down and I can see the context of the tweet I'm replying to. I can also scroll around, and here's a pretty cool thing. If you tap on any link in a tweet, it'll automatically get added to the tweet you're composing. So I'm going to tap on this URL from David Poe, and there it is. I can also scroll around, and let's see if I can find a reference to a person here, there, from David Poe. There's that. I tap on that, and that address gets added automatically to my tweet. So it's a really quick sort of copy and paste-like way to pick up some items. Tap on the funnel icon in the bottom left corner and it brings up the filtering view. This is my timeline filtered to just mentions of me. If I tap on the star, I can see my favorites. The envelope will give me my direct messages and the person will give me my tweets that I've sent. So it's a really quick way to filter your view. Now, if you tap on the upper right corner on the font toggle, you can make a small, medium, or large font size, which is very convenient. If you tap the sources arrow to the back left, you'll go to the sources view, and this is support for multiple accounts. I have the JSnell account and the Macworld account. In fact, I've got the Macworld account set to only show references to Macworld, which is useful. That's how I use that account to reply to things. Now, there's save searches here built in. I can see the tweets sent by people who are nearby using my location, using the iPhone's GPS. I can also make more advanced searches here. I can do a quick search, look at the trends list of the currently trending topics on Twitter. If I tap on Wolverine, I'm going to see tweets about Wolverine. If I scroll up to the quick search view, you can see that you have a pretty powerful search engine here if you want to have access to Twitter's search engine from right within Twitterific. So that's all pretty cool, and that's new. Tap the edit button. You can add as many new accounts as you like, basically, and you can add some saved searches if you want as well, if they're things that you find yourself searching for all the time. Now I'm going to select a tweet and tap on the asterisk button, and you'll see a lot of options for what I can do with the tweet. I can link it, I can retweet it, and I can get information about the person who sent this tweet. In this case, I'm going to tap on the author, and that will automatically bring up the author information for the person who sent that tweet. Pretty convenient, and we've seen this panel before. Now, if the tweet you tap on is a reply, there's a new interesting option, the thread button. Tap on that, and what you'll see is, in this example, Peter is responding to a tweet from Jim, who's responding to a tweet from me. So it's a great way to view an entire conversation if you're wondering what the context is. Now let's switch to the settings view. There are lots of settings in this version of Twitterific. You've got three themes to choose from, a dark one, a light one, and a sort of in-between one, depending on your mood. There are lots of advanced features, including some pretty cool tap, double tap, and triple tap shortcuts that you can set. But these expose the Twitterific 2 features in a way that I really like, that's much more easy to use. So let's go into my timeline here and you'll see if I tap on this tweet and tap on the avatar, I immediately see all the user information for that user. It's very convenient. If I double tap on a message, I will automatically get the conversation thread. So you can do it really quickly and that's a nice shortcut. So there's a quick tour of Twitterific 2.0, which comes again in two versions, a free version with ads and a premium version where you pay a little bit and then there are no ads. Now, before we go, I want to show you quickly two other Twitter apps. Tweety, which is excellent, from 8-bits, and Big Stone Phone's Twiddlator Pro, which is not really my cup of tea, but let me tell you, it is a powerful app with every feature known to man. So, let's take a look at those now. Just a quick overview of Tweety. It's a Twitter client, so it's got a list of messages, and in this case, what you do is you toggle between tweets and mentions and messages and favorites with the toolbar icons down at the bottom. And what you do is you tap on a message in order to see it in detail and then act upon the items in it, like an at reference or a web link in this case. And here it is loaded in the built-in browser. And like many other Twitter clients, there's an action item, including the ability to add it to Instapaper. Again, a very cool thing. Again, check it out. Instead of having a conversation thread view, Tweety lets you backtrack to see the previous message. So you see this in reply button there, and I tap on that, and I see the previous message, and I tap on that, and I see the originating message. So a lot of the same features, just sort of done in a different way. Now, Twitterlator Pro, you can see here, there are so many different places to tap on here. You can see more information about these tweets. You can toggle between friends and messages and mentions. And the More button has huge amounts of material. And then there's the Settings. And you can set it to do almost anything you want. There's a huge amount of customizability here. So it's kind of complicated. It's not really for me. But boy, if you ever felt like a Twitter app wasn't doing exactly what you wanted to, give a look at Twitterlator Pro because it really does everything. There's, I think, not a thing on Twitter that you can do on the Twitter website or with a Twitter API that you cannot do somehow, some way with Twitterlator Pro. So three Twitter apps for the iPhone. The brand new Twitterific 2.0 from the Icon Factory, Tweety from 8-bits, and Twitterlator Pro from Big Stone Phone. Definitely check them out on the App Store, and I think you'll really be interested in Twitterific 2. It is my favorite, although Tweety is great too. So really, if you're a Twitter user and an iPhone user, there are so many great apps out there, and I hope that you'll consider these three. Once again, I'm Jason Snell, editorial director at Macworld. Thanks for watching.